Hello, this video will help you understand how to deploy an operating system on the devices in your network by using the OS Deployment Wizard. OS Deployment is a limited module and requires the deployment license. First, we need to set up the device that is responsible for creating deployment projects. From the wizard's menu, select OS Deployment. In the OSD Manager window, click Add Device. Select the device to be added as a device manager and click OK. Click Next. In the OSD Manager configuration window, confirm the path specified in the Windows ADK path, TFTP local path, and driver root folder fields. If you need to modify a value, click Select. Click Test. The agent verifies the Windows ADK installation and updates the status accordingly. The status field displays the configuration verification status of the OSD Manager. To verify, click Check Environment. You cannot proceed until the environment check is complete and the status changes to OK. If the OSD Manager is also a network boot listener, verify the values specified in the network boot listener section to define the parameters of this role. Let's keep these values unchanged and click Next to proceed. The deployment type window is displayed. Let's select the setup mode and click Next. The project parameters window is displayed. Enter the name of the new project into the name field. Select the architecture type to apply to the project from the architecture drop-down list. Select the type of BIOS mode supported by the project, that is either UEFI or legacy deployments or both. Let's select both. Select the driver letter for the drive on which the new OS is to be installed. To manually add the required drivers, select the Disable Automated Driver Detection option. If you do not want to use the model drivers, clear the Use Model Drivers checkbox. If you want to use Multicast to deploy the OS to the targets, select the Deployment by Multicast option. The Cache Location list defines the location to download the cache. The Delete Cache list defines when the downloaded material is deleted on the client. Click Next. In the image window, you can define the operating system image to be used for the project. You can either select an existing image or create a new one to be deployed by the setup. Let's create a new image. Click Next to go to the image parameters window where you can define the parameters of the new image. Enter the image name. Enter the network path to the image or setup folder where the image files are located in the location field. Enter the login credentials to access the network location and read and write mode in the connection parameters fields. To verify, click Check Image. After status OK is displayed, click Next. The OS drivers window is only applicable to a setup deployment or a SysPrepVim image deployment. In this window, you can specify additional drivers for devices that are not yet connected to the machine, such as printer drivers. Let's click Next. In the target list configuration window, you can select the deployment targets. Targets are managed via target lists. Let's select Create a new target list and click Next. In the target list window, you can define new deployment targets. Enter the name of the new target list. Click Create a new target. Select PXE subnet filter. Specify the IP range and click OK. Click Next. The MBR disk configuration window enables you to define the configuration of the disk on which the operating system should be installed for legacy installations. Select the required disk configuration for the project and click Next. The GPT disk configuration window enables you to define the UEFI configuration of the disk on which the operating system should be installed. Select the required disk configuration for the project and click Next. In the deployment drivers window, you can select the drivers required for the WinP. Let's use the default option and click Next. In the PXE menu parameters window, you can add the new project to a PXE start menu to make it available whenever this menu is used on the subnet. Let's leave this option unselected and click Next. In the project build date window, define the schedule for the project build and its activation. Let's select immediately and click Finish. The dashboard tab is displayed. The build status field shows the progress of the deployment. After the OS is deployed on the target list we specified in the project, the build successful status is displayed. You have now understood how to deploy an operating system on the target devices by using the setup mode. For more information about this topic, see the BMC online documentation portal. Thanks for watching.